We are one step closer to have the Starship Flight 5 because recently we have done the booster to a static fire campaign, and that static fire was anticipated earlier, and we have been awaited for this since the Starship Flight 4 happened. Because the Starship Flight 4 has been grabbed the attention of the many Starship fans, because the Starship Flight 4 was a successful attempted Starship flight ever in the history, because the recent the three flights were fully failed, but the fourth flight is a perfect with the flawless any anomaly. So because we are getting more exciting for the Starship Flight 5, which will be a conduct in a early August or in a August. We can't say anything. It depends on SpaceX that what they are doing right now, because SpaceX is under preparation to prepare the both vehicle. Like the recently they have done the static fire of the booster 12 with the one cryo test and one cryo proof test, because on the 11th July we have saw the all closure has been set up there and the road closed, and then the entire GSE system, like the venting and any other things, has been starting going on. And next we are anticipated for the static fire, but unfortunately we got the cryoproof. The booster 12 has been filled partially with the NN2, means the nitrogen, to verify the internal vents or any other things is working well or not. So then later that day and after that day, on 12 July, we have done the spin prime test of a 33 engine of the study, like booster 12. The 33 Raptor engines have conducted the spin prime test. Since they have conducted, because the spin prime test, we are likely to skip since the booster 11 and booster 10, because in earlier in a booster 9 we have done the spin prime, but the next flew booster didn't done the spin prime. They really did take the direct jump onto the static fire. But right now we are just proofing and verifying our system that are really working well or not. So that's usable. So then after the 2 days, on the 15th July, we finally got our real thing that what we have been anticipated for. The static fire has come along with the booster all test, and the static fire has been conducted on a Monday, the 15th July. And it was a successful full duration static fire, but I haven't measured the whole thing. That static fire was 8 seconds exceeded, almost 2 and 3 seconds exceeded from its the full duration. Means the static fire was a fully mature, is not premature. So then let's jump on to another topic, because the booster 12 has been brought back to the production side yesterday. And along with the rollout of the booster 12, we have another thing at the Starbase. The pad B is a tower B is likely to be done within 4 months, because this module 2 has been brought and arrived at the Starbase like a launch site, and it's the waiting for it the stacking procedure. But after the static fire of the booster 12, the SpaceX they finally stacked the tower to tower B, whatever you call this, but I am called the tower B. So the tower B, the second module, has been stacked over the module 1, and that was a quick succession. Like that was a quick process that the SpaceX can do within 2 days, because they are very, because there is a prefabricated parts that never be a conduct like created by another way. So that's why we are creating too, and that's why we are believing on SpaceX more than other company. So that's why. And another thing that happened over the Starbase is the ship 30 hit us preparation. After the Starship Flight 4, we finally bought many things that should be a change well. Because after the configuration of the Flight 4, we have learned the lesson from it that we should change over the thermal protection system. That is the biggest flaw for our mission. So then the SpaceX have decided to change the 18,000 hexagonal thermal tile system on a Ship 30. And right now they are nearly the completion of 18,000 version 2 thermal protection tiles. So they are near to be complete, and it will be complete in a couple hours of day. In a few days ahead, they will complete it, done. And then we finally getting into a pace where the SpaceX will do more better than the another company, because they has been doing this. They has a legacy in a space fair. But right now the SpaceX is little stumble over the ground, because the recently the Falcon 9 anomaly, due to the Falcon 9 anomaly, the SpaceX Starlink mission has been stopped for the temporary reasons that the second stage hasn't been reignited, and it leads the route in the mid-flight because of the fuel leakage that we have seen after the stage separation. And that leak were the coming out from the broken insulation, which wasn't clearly have been seen. The powerhouse of the Merlin engine has been broken, and it still fully mature to provide the sufficient thrust to reach almost the 25,000 kilometer per hour beyond. But that wasn't the real perigee velocity that we can raise the perigee aspect. So unfortunately the SpaceX have demolished the all deployed satellite due to the orbit. So it's unfortunate moment for us, because it occasionally happened, not usually happen. I don't know who cursed us. But yes, SpaceX have grounded due to the FAA statement that have been told to the SpaceX. They have been told to the SpaceX that you all should have to the re-evaluate, re-evaluate the data from the flight, stage 2, that where it did go wrong and what is the problem exactly in the Merlin and what is the causes of the failure. So the all thing will be a re-evaluate, and might they have done the all thing. But the only thing is a need to apply the revaluation data to the FAA. Then the FAA will be announced that the SpaceX is can do a process of the launching their vehicle and continue their all things. So that has been a fully catastrophic event, but it's not the fully very high and very bad for the SpaceX. SpaceX is a never be a stop and a stationary position. It's going through all things. It doesn't matter. We have been accused the many F9 failure before, but this problem was rare to be happen. So it doesn't matter. And after that, we finally going to see the Starship Flight 5 will be a conduct in August. That my speculation. I don't know what behind the people are saying. But I am saying the Flight 5 will be occurred within August or after the August, means in September, due to the some reason. The first reason was, there because it has been there due to the Flight 4. The Flight 4, the some configurations that has been released, and that we have to do the configuration in our new vehicles that are very designated for the Flight 5. Due to that, we finally got stuck into the process that changing the all hardwares and software side, reinforcement and all other things that should be done for the lead the reliable and flawless flight. So that all thing is completely in a process. So we are still waiting for to get repair orbital launch mount, get it done the both vehicles, and might the ship 30 will conduct the static fire at the masses in a few weeks, and we will see the ship 30 stars again. And recently, do you know that, guys? The recently we have been spotted the block 2, the starship nose cone, at the star production site. And that nose cone was came out from the star factory, and it just went to high bay one. Yeah, it went to the high bay, not the mega bay. It went to the high bay where the ship 30 already has been placed for the its stars replacement. So the nose cone was levered the upward, and all flaps is a very good looking for the block 2, and they are looking very very sufficient for the reflect and deflect the all re-entry atmosphere. So the finally the SpaceX is a god and legend. The nobody can beat the SpaceX because of their bravery and the risk taking ability. Whatever they are doing, we are appreciating a lot of them. So the bye all of guys, my name is Gaurav Joshi and you're watching the NASA Directory. Might you will find this video in a later in the future, but you have to see on this date when my generation is watching this entire rocket system that can be a reusable. Is fully fortunate to us, and I feel very fortunate to have the witnessing the all things that the Starship is doing, and the SpaceX entire take is beyond your imagination. So the bye all of my name is Gaurav Joshi. I'm reminding you because my name is also Indian name. So let's bye guys. I will be later. Bye. Witnessing a starship escaping a gravity is my primary goal to see, and this is an emotion beyond my imagination. I feel very proud to be see the starship. I feel very proud to be part of this mission, part of this community where the people are anticipating the starship launch every month.